in a barren, dry and rocky world the keyword left abandoned, an almost unmodified race of post-humans, with the intelligence level of a caveman, whose activity on the ruins of both Kew and Ktar person, prentate them to advance at a rapid pace, faster than that of its small beastly cousins on other, more fictitious worlds. Due to their knowledge about these Ktar people and the Kew, the Runehorbers were able to develop a civilization that gave them an egg sheath that matched that of the Astromyth, and also led to them to see their heritage as the sole heirs of these Ktar people. However, it also led them to develop perhaps too quickly, having many resources. The Runehorbers' first wars were nuclear and savage, making them go through a baptism of fire. Just as their species might have been melted by catastrophe, so would their bodies, for the sun of their rocky and dry planet started to undergo a rapid phase of expansion, and the species, advanced as it was, could do nothing to stop the process. So the Horners did the next best thing, and changed their bodies. The infernal conditions of the solar expansion meant that a biological reconstruction was totally out of the question. Thus, the Horners replaced their bodies with machines, floating spheres of metal that moved and melted the environment through subtle manipulations of gravity fields. In earlier versions, these spheres still cradled the organic brains of the last Horners. But in successive generations, ways of containing the mind within quantum computers were devised, and the transformation became absolute. The Runehorbers were no more alien. Now there was the completely mechanical Gravibe. They had to destroy their biological bodies to save themselves. Their spherical robotic bodies floated among the ruins of their now infernal planet, and soon enough others of an immediate solar system. Their artificial bodies made space travel easy for them, and they started colonizing other planets. After the lesson of the Kew, the Second Galactic Empire kept a constant watch against alien invasion. Ironically, they neglected to look among themselves. Recall that most Runehorbers were already aware of being the sole inheritors of these Ktar men. They refused to communicate with their relatives on other planets, and kept to their own affairs. While not even organic, the Gravibe still retained dreams, desires, ambitions, and what makes many humans special, their ability to do evil. After long preparations, including developing better bodies capable of interstellar travel, the Gravibe began to wipe out their post-human cousins and all other organic life within about 10,000 years. Traveling in great geometrical ships capable of withstanding the unforgiving void of space and armed with cannons and a few hundred convoys of Gravibes, they would block suns with million-mile wide black sails and, finishing the worlds inhabited by their inferior cousins via orbital bombardment. Almost all life went extinct. The only biological species that survived the invasion were the bug faces, for reasons still not completely understood, for they were left alive and redeveloped through genetic engineering into the subjects. The actions of the Gravibles can easily seem misleading and despicable, and they might seem as merely evil. However, this isn't the case, for they are not without personality. Although machines, they still contain hopes, dreams, affection and love. Here we can hear a pair of Gravibles in a radio conversation. As well as a conversation among Gravibe leaders prior to the destruction of a planet. And here we can hear the battle cry they would play whenever arriving to a new planet just before the bombardment saw the blackenings. And lastly, a gravital family conversation. One must understand that they were like clock pinch villains. Genocide was their ideal and their job, but at the end of the day, life wasn't something of importance to them, let alone something that could suffer love. And every so often they would return home to greet and love their families, just as we do today after a long day of work.